Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today's topic of my video is Indian English Literature. In this video, we'll discuss about three main pillars of Indian English Literature, three leading authors and pioneers of Indian English Literature, Mulkraj Anand, R.K. Narayan and Raja Rao. But before going to these authors, let's discuss about what Indian English literature is and brief history of Indian English literature. Now, what is Indian English literature? Indian English literature is a work of writers in India who write in English language. Indian English literature is also called Indo-Anglican literature. Indo-Anglican literature is very much different from Anglo-Indian literature. Indo-Anglican literature is called Indian English literature, whereas Anglo-Indian literature is very much different. Now, who are Anglo-Indians? Anglo-Indians are the people with the mixed ancestries. That is, one of the parents is Indian and the another is Britisher. Anglo-Indian also stands for the people who are born in British and are living in India. So, Indian English literature is called Indo-Anglican literature and not Anglo-Indian literature. Now, let's see the brief history of Indian English literature. The first book written by an Indian in English is Travels of Dean Mohammed, published in 1793 and was written by Saqe Dean Mohammed. It was the first book written by an Indian in English, whereas the first novel written by an Indian in English is Raj Mohan's Wife, published in 1864. Raj Mohan's Wife was written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, who was also the composer of Vande Mataram. So, Raj Mohan's Wife was the first Indian novel in English. First translator who translated Indian language into European language was Kesari Mohan Ganguly. And he translated Mahabharat, the epic, into English language. The first epic which was translated into English language was Mahabharat, and it was translated by Kesari Mohan Ganguly. The book was in the name of Mahabharat, the Mahabharat of Krishna. Dwaipayana Vyasa translated into English. This was the title of the book, and Kesari Mohan Ganguly was the first Indian translator who translated Mahabharat epic into English. Now, Dhan Gopal Mukherjee, he was the first Indian author to win a literary award outside India. And he won a literary award in US. So, Dhan Gopal Mukherjee was the first Indian author to receive literary award in US, outside India. P. Pal, he founded press in 1950s for Indian English writings only. Now, let's come to our three main leading pillars of Indian English literature, Mulkraj Anand, R.K. Narayan and Raja Rao. Now, first discuss with Raja Rao. His time span was from 1908 to 2006. And he was novels and short story writer. And he was the first philosopher in Indian English writing. He is known for his philosophical works. Raja Rao was the first philosopher in Indian English writings. His first and foremost novel was Kanthapura, published in 1938. Second one was The Serpent and the Rope, 1960. Another is The Cat and Shakespeare, 1965. It is his metaphysical poetry. The Cow of the Barricades is the short story. So, these are some of the important works of Raja Rao, And the first important work is Kanthapura. Now let's see what is Kanthapura. Kanthapura is the novel which was published in 1938 and it was his first and best novel. It was his masterpiece. It is about the South Indian village called Kanthapura. And Kanthapura is known for its narration style. The novel is narrated in the form of Sthal Purana. Now, what is Sthal Purana in the form of Sthal Purana? Actually, ancient Puranic style is different from Western style of narration. Ancient Puranic style is used in this rather than Western style. In ancient Puranic style, the storytelling is done without any break. Unlike Western style, there is no division into chapters. So this novel is without any break, without any division into chapters. So Kanthapura is known for its narrative style, which is in the form of Sthal Purana. And it is narrated by an old woman, Achakka. In Kanthapura, the village is protected by local deity, Kanchama. Kanchama is the local deity which was protected. Who protected? Kanthapura. Kanthapura is narrated by old woman Achakka. The main protagonist of this novel is Murthy. The novel shows strong, deep-rooted caste system prevalent in then society. Murthy, he was very much influenced by Gandhian philosophy. This novel deals with civil disobedience movement. Civil disobedience movement was in 1930s. This story is told during 1930s when civil disobedience movement was there. This story was told by Achakka. She was Brahmin, old woman. And she tells the story about Murthy, who is also Brahmin. His next important novel is The Serpent and the Rope. Serpent and the Rope is his autobiographical novel, his semi-autobiographical novel. And it was the second novel written by Raja Rao. The main protagonist is Rama Swami. The Serpent and the Rope shows the failed marriage of Rama, who belongs to India, and Madeleine, who belonged to France. So in this novel, The Serpent and the Rope, the clash of Eastern and Western culture is shown. Rama's thought process was influenced by Vedantic philosophy and Adi Shankara's non-dualism. The major awards which he got was Padma Vibhushan, which was conferred to him in 2007, and he died at the age of 2006. So this award was given to him posthumously. Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian award, was conferred to him in 2007 posthumously after his death. Sahitya Akademi Award in 1964, and he got Neustadt International Prize in Literature in 1988. So these were the three major awards which were conferred to him. Now let's come to R.K. Narayan. R.K. Narayan, his time span was from 1906 to 2001. His brother's name was L.K. Lakshman and he was the famous cartoonist. R.K. Narayan, his full name was Rassipuram Krishna Swami Iyer Narayan Swami. Like Thomas Hardy is known for his creation of fictional city, Wessex City. Similarly, R.K. Narayan is known for creating fictional South Indian town, Malgudi. Now, where is Malgudi? Malgudi was located, it is a fictional town and it was located in the banks of fictional river Sarayu, near fictional forest Mempi. So Malgudi, the fictional town, is located on the banks of fictional river Sarayu and near fictional forest, Mempi Forest. R.K. Narayan was the friend of Graham Greene, who was responsible for publishing his first novel and other novels also. Graham Greene was responsible for publishing his first novels, Swami and Friends. R.K. Narayan's first novel was Swami and Friends. And the fictional town Malgudi was first introduced in this novel. R.K. Narayan has written three semi-autobiographical trilogy. Like Raja Rao's, his semi-autobiographical novel was The Serpent and the Rope, and R.K. Narayan's semi-autobiographical trilogy has novels Swami and Friends, The Bachelor of Arts, and The English Teacher. Now, let's come to Swami and Friends. Now, Swami and Friends deals with his childhood days, The Bachelor of Arts deals with adolescent age, and English Teacher deals with his after-marriage age. Now, Swami and Friends, it deals with his childhood days. The main theme is innocence of youth. Swami and Friends, in this, the fictional town Malgudi was first introduced. Main hero is Swaminathan. And his friends were Rajam and Mani. Mani was his best friend. Bachelor of Arts, it deals with its adolescent age. And in this, the main protagonist is Chandran. Chandran fell in love with a girl, but he could not marry since his horoscope describes him Mangali. And he fell in love with Malati, but she married someone else. And with this, he got frustrated and desperate and he became sannyasi. After 8 months of his sannyasi period, he thinks about his parents. And then he returns home and again he thinks of marriage. But he was unable to get Malati out of head completely. So he marries Sushila. And at the end of the novel, it is seen that he fell in love with her. Now, the third novel in his trilogy is The English Teacher, published in 1945. This novel is dedicated to Narayan's wife, Rajam, who died of tuberculosis in 1939. And this is also the story of a protagonist Krishna, who loved his wife Sushila and who died. Sushila died of tuberculosis. So this is the novel dedicated to Narayan's wife Rajam. This novel, which was published in 1945 in the name of English Teacher, was published in 1953, again republished under the name Grateful of Life and Death. R.K. Narayan is also known as Indian Chekhov. Now, due to his similarities in their writings. And his writing style is also compared to William Faulkner. His main works are The Guide, in which the main protagonist was Raju. The Guide was adopted in Hindi film Guide also. His masterpiece is The Financial Expert, whose theme is lust for money. This is his masterpiece. And it is a true story of Margaya. Margaya means one who shows the way. This story shows the rise and fall of Margaya, who sits under banyan tree, advising people in helping money borrowing at small interest from bank. So this Financial Expert is the story about Margaya, who sits under banyan tree, and it shows rise and fall of this protagonist. The notable awards which he got was Padma Vibhushan, again the second highest civilian award, which was conferred to him in 2001. Sahitya Academy Award for his book The Guide in 1958, A.C. Benson Medal, British Royal Society, Award 1980 and Padma Bhushan in 1964. And he was also the reporter of the newspaper The Justice. His notable novels are Swami and Friends, The Bachelor of Arts, The Dark Room, The English Teacher, Mr. Sampath, The Financial Expert, Waiting for Mahatma, The Man-Eater of Malgudi, God's Demon and others, The Emerald Root, Malgudi Days, Under the Banyan Tree and other stories, Talkative Man, A Woman's Nightmare. These are some of his important work. And The Financial Expert is his masterpiece. Now, let's see Mulk Raj Anand. His time span was from 1905 to 2004. Mulk Raj Anand is also known as India's Charles Dickens. Like Charles Dickens depicted the life of the people, life of the poor people living in his society, in the same way, Mulk Raj Anand is also associated, also notable for depiction of the lives of poor castes. And he was also notable for incorporating Punjabi and Hindustani idioms in English. So he incorporated Punjabi and Hindustani idioms in English also. Important awards which he got were Padma Bhushan in 1967 and Sahitya Academy Award for his book The Morning Face in 1968. His first important novel is Untouchable. Untouchable is his masterpiece. It is the story of a single day in the life of Bakha. Bakha is the main protagonist. Bakha was a toilet cleaner who accidentally bumps into the member of a higher caste. And the introduction of this novel was given by E.M. Forster. Untouchable was set in the fictional Indian town Bulashah. Now the second important poem, second important novel is Kuli, whose main protagonist was Munnu, and he was orphan and 14-year-old boy. In this novel, the plight of Munnu due to his poverty is shown, and how he was exploited is shown. Two Leaves and a Bird is the story about the exploitation of coolies working in tea garden at the hands of British officials. Some of his important works are Untouchable, 1935 published, Kuli, The Two Leaves and a Bud, The Village, Across the Black Waters, The Sword and the Sickle, The Private Life of Indian Prime. Now, like the semi-autobiographical trilogy of R.K. Narayan, he had also written a trilogy whose novels are in which the main novels are The Village, Across the Black Waters, and The Sword and the Sickle. It is the trilogy about rebellious adolescence and his experience in World War I. So, the books in the trilogy include The Village, Across the Black Waters, The Sword and the Sickle, and it is the trilogy about rebellious adolescent and his experience in World War I. Mulk Raj Anand is also associated with his reputed journal Marg. Marg is devoted to arts. So the author which is associated with reputed journal Marg is Mulk Raj Anand. Thank you friends. If you like my video, then please like, subscribe and share my video. In the next video, I'll be discussing about Indian diasporic literature. Thank you.